Contacts, it is never a bad thing. Loan officers cannot close loans to people they don't talk to. So there's a couple things with respect to contacts. Good quality leads. Hey, I got three went into processing. I'm working them. Oh, you know what? I worked them or talked to people, but they didn't go anywhere. Rotate them. You probably can't change your comp waffly. Go, hey, I'm going to pay you more to close this lead. But you know what you can do? Hey, we're going to rotate these on the second pass. We're going to give you a dinner to whatever. Here's a Starbucks card or whatever you want to do. But you can get somebody to go, well, this lead's already been worked. Yeah, but you know what? It's a guy we were talking to 2-3 times. Charlie, you give another shot. I'm going to push those to you. And as an attaboy, you're going to get, you know, something that's lawfully compliant, probably not a thing of value. but you know, you give them an attaboy to give that lead another shot. The other side, you know, maybe you got 20, you got good notes, high customer engagement, but nothing's moving forward. So I see guys that talk to customers in our system all the time, and I'll talk to their sales manager and say, well, you know, because we'll, hey, what's going on? Oh, can you look at this? And I'll be like, you need to get Bobby some sales training. I bet he doesn't ask for the business. Why don't you go have somebody sit and listen to him? Because you'll see where a team of 3 or 4 loan officers are all moving forward with good lead bases, and this one guy, good notes, talking to people, but nothing's moving forward. Train your loan officer before you burn out the leads you gave him. And in the end, if you do all this, you can lead by intelligent design. You know, if you put all this together, whether you use LoanTek or not, you know, you can make loans and you can grow your pipeline. Don't get too far out in front of yourselves with your ROI and your investments, right? Because leads are expensive. Your average lead shop, you know, even individuals, I think if they start getting into this, they're going to spend $500 or $1,000 just to get started. You know, branches, you know, some branches $2,000-$3,000 a month, some $20,000-$30,000. It depends how big you scale it. Don't get too out in front of it until you got the tools to manage it. And if you manage it, you invest in it, you should get an intelligent ROI out of it.